Hey guys, what's up? This is Emmy and Basis. The next show on my list is Trading Spaces, Boys vs. Girls. Now, this is one of my top 5 most favorite, greatest TV shows on the Discovery Kids while it was still going. This is my number 2 favorite, number 1 being Mystery Hunters, but this is my number 2. Now, I'll tell you why it's my favorite in just a second, because Trading Spaces, Boys vs. Girls is basically about a show where kids spend the night at their opponent's house and building the dream room that a kid wants. And believe me, they get it done, and I've seen some cool-ass rooms, which I'll explain in a minute. Now, Diane Mazzotta was the host for the first 3 seasons, and Chuck Creel, he was the host for the last 4, I mean for the last season. And of course you had your designers, Jordan Ruderman and Scott Sicari, and your carpenters, Janine Licata and Bart Shadlow. Now, I love Bart Shadlow. He's fucking badass. He is badass. And then you had your guest appearances from Mia Hamm, and the people from Spy Kids, Daryl Sabara and Alex Vega. That is awesome. And then they had one of the people from NASA, I forgot who it was. And they had somebody named Carter Oosterhaus, but I don't know who the hell that is. But now, of course they do have challenges, like a setback challenge. I think they did 2 of them. You can have the labor saber, and then the second one, you have the labor sabers or the clue box for the second challenge. Now, okay. So the reason why it's my second favorite is because they have some cool-ass rooms. And that's where it ties into, what are the cool-ass rooms? Well, to answer those 2 questions at the same time, they build whatever they want. You can build a rainforest room, a basketball room, an obstacle course room, 50s diner, a movie star room, a swimming pool room. How fucking cool would it be just to have a freaking diving board in your room and go swimming every day? It's fucking awesome. Have a surf shack, maybe like a skateboard room, a coffee shop room where you have like your own latte machine, everything, have a counter, a real register and all that shit, underwater room, a safari room, a winter room, a saloon room, a log cabin room, like Mardi Gras. Hell, it could be Mardi Gras here every day. You could have like a huge city, a palace, you know, anything basically under the sun. But my favorite room of all time was the, I think it was the garage band thing, where the dude had like a garage band. That was my favorite. That was my first favorite. My second favorite was the football and the candy room. That candy room was just, oh dude, the candy factory. So freaking yummy. I mean, God, you had all this candy. Who would not want a candy room? Your bed made out of candy. Have a jar full of candy. Have your own candy elevator, which you could get all your candy. Candy hanging from your ceiling, your walls. You know, it's like Willy Wonka's come to town in your room. It's that amazing. That's why this show is so cool. It should have never fucking ended. This is like the dream show for kids. I wish I had my room done like that. Shit, I would have a freaking dragon room in here. I'd have dragons everywhere. Fucking ended the show. I didn't even know about it. I thought it was still going. I did not discover this channel until like 2006, 2007. So the show ended beforehand, which sucks. Plus, I didn't live in the California area, But who gives a fuck, though? They make a ton of money out of this shit. Anyways, the reason why this show got canceled, I don't know, but from what I saw last time on when I was reading the info about this, is that Chuck decided to basically end the show. But I cannot confirm that because that little piece of information is now gone. So it's not there anymore. Now, it could be probably because of money or whatever, just because of the ratings, but I don't know. Why would they care about ratings on this? This is a fucking awesome golden show. I mean, it's, wow, that good. Now, how would it come back? On what channel? I'd have to say on the Hub, because I think the Hub could probably pull this show off if they get all the original people back. I mean, they could probably have 2 second hosts, maybe like, maybe Scott, no, not Scott, Diane could host the girls, Chuck could host the boys, you know, back and forth. And then while Scott and Janine, Bart and Jordan are doing their work, you could have the boys, like, check in, like, teams and stuff. You don't have to run to each other's houses and stuff and whatnot. Have them two working at the same time. Now, how would it keep going, basically? That just said half of it there, which is my mistake. But, you know, there's kids who would probably enjoy this. Like, you know, it could build different rooms, you know? I haven't seen, I have not seen an anime room. I have not seen, actually, yeah, I have seen a disco room. I haven't seen, like, yeah, I've seen a castle room. A waterfall room? Maybe, like, what's another room? Pokemon room? Maybe, whatever room they want it to be, basically. And, probably, you know, maybe make it, like, around the States for kids, you know? That would be cool, instead of just that one little California area. I hate when they just base things off in California. It's cool, but go around, you know? There's a bunch of kids out here. The show could have been lasting for a very long time. Now, of course, since the Discovery Kids thing is gone, I guess the Hub would probably have to get the rights, but they've already probably already shown some of the episodes that have probably got it now, so it's probably something. So, right, guys, this is Emmy Basis. I talked to Inor Ranted about Training Spaces, Boys vs. Girls, and I hope y'all have a good day or night when you're watching this. Thanks.